In this video, we are going to learn about sharks, huh? Sharks, this is a video so many of you have asked for. It's time. It's time for the shark video! Sharks are an amazing type of fish in the ocean. Isn't that interesting? Sharks are fish. Sharks are amazing fish. Now, the picture most of us have in our minds when we think of sharks isn't always the case. You see, there are 440 types of sharks, and they can be quite different from one another. For example, the whale shark is the largest type of shark. It gets over 40 feet long. Wow! But the dwarf lantern shark is the smallest shark. It is only about 6 inches and can fit in your hand. Yeah. Wow, this is not what most people picture when they picture a shark. But the dwarf lantern shark is just as much a shark as the whale shark is. Remember, there are 440 types of sharks, so they don't all look like this guy, you know? Here's the thing, even though there are so many different types of sharks, all sharks have certain things in common. For example, sharks don't have any bones. The skeleton of a shark is made of cartilage. That goes for all sharks. Sharks don't have bones, and it's interesting because most other fish do have bones, but sharks don't. Okay, so the skeleton of a shark is made of cartilage, but what is cartilage? What does that mean? What is cartilage? Okay, this is gonna sound weird, but touch your ears and move them around with your fingers. That rubbery material in your ear is called cartilage. Isn't that amazing? There's some cartilage in your body, just like there's cartilage in the body of a shark. The skeleton of a shark is made of cartilage, which makes a shark very flexible, kind of like your ears, right? Your ears were kind of rubbery and flexible when you touched them. That's the way the skeleton of a shark is, which helps a shark move around in special ways. It makes a shark very flexible. Hey, you want to know what's not flexible?
Shark's teeth!
Shark's teeth! This is interesting. A shark uses its teeth to bite, but not to chew. Whatever they bite that goes into their mouths, sharks swallow whole. We use our teeth not just to bite, but to chew. But a shark only uses its teeth to bite. And a shark can have a lot of teeth in its lifetime. Now here's the crazy part. A shark may have as many as 20,000 teeth during its life. There are rows of replacement teeth that in case a tooth gets broken or falls off and gets lost, a new tooth emerges. Now, we've already mentioned there are 440 types of sharks. In fact, you're probably sick of hearing the fact that there are 440 types of sharks. How many types of sharks are there? How many? 440. All right, we're going to just show you four of our favorites. There are a lot of other cool sharks. We're missing a lot of them. We're going to show you four sharks right now so that if you see these sharks in the future, you'll be like, oh, I know what type of shark that is. The first shark is the whale shark, and we've already talked about how the whale shark is the largest shark in the world. Yeah, but what's cool about whale sharks, they have these white spots, and they're very gentle. So even though they're huge, they're very gentle. In fact, some whale sharks have even let divers sit on top of them. How would you like to ride a whale shark? What? Next, we're going to show you the great white shark, perhaps the most famous shark of them all. This is the shark that most people think of when they think of sharks, and the great white shark is really intense. 23 feet long, and they eat all kinds of things. Dolphins, sea lions, whales, seals, and even other sharks. Next is the hammerhead shark, which gets its name because its head looks like a hammer, which it kind of sounds like a mean name. Like, you know, some of the other sharks were like, hey, hammerhead. And he was like, hey, you know, don't call me that. But, you know, the name kind of stuck. The hammerhead shark, it's interesting. That's actually an advantage for the hammerhead shark. It helps with the swimming and also helps with the eyesight. The eyesight of the hammerhead shark is much better, especially at gauging distance, than other sharks. Finally, there's the Thresher shark. The Thresher shark is a very strong shark known for its very, very long tail. And that tail can be huge. In fact, the tail of a Thresher shark can weigh as many as 300 pounds or more. Wow, the Thresher shark. Those are just four amazing types of sharks. We left out so many. But just understand, sharks are incredible creatures. And as humans, we need sharks. A lot of people don't realize how much we need sharks. You see, sharks have an important job, a very important job, and it's not babysitting fish, because Fred, I don't trust you with Henry. I really don't. I really don't think that you can be trusted with Henry, because I think what we're looking at here is a snack time, all right? And you're just not the best babysitter, okay? I don't really trust that Henry's gonna make it through, okay? So what is a shark's important job? What do sharks do? Here's their job. Sharks balance the ocean ecosystem. The ocean just wouldn't run as well without sharks. And there are a lot of ways that sharks balance the ocean ecosystem. But we're going to give you one specific way just so you can see how important sharks are. So here is our example. Sharks feed on herbivores that eat coral reef. And you might say, well, how does that impact us? How is that important? Well, in places where there aren't enough sharks, coral reef has been wiped out and it's replaced with this gross, nasty algae. It's not just coral reef that gets affected. All different types of creatures in the ocean would be affected by that. The balance is held together by these amazing fish called sharks with a skeleton made of cartilage that work hard to balance the ocean. Even though they don't realize what they're doing, they're helping maintain the diversity and the beauty of the ocean. Now here's the sad part. 100 million sharks are killed every year by people. Think about that. 100 million sharks are killed every year by people. Thankfully, there are organizations that are working to protect sharks. We need sharks. Sharks aren't bad. They're not mean. They're not evil. They balance the ocean ecosystem. They have a very important job, and they need to be left alone, and they need to be protected. One final note before we leave. You know, a lot of people misunderstand sharks and think that sharks are mean. But sharks don't like biting people. When a shark bites someone, it is because they think that that person is a sea creature. In other words, sharks like to leave us alone and they want to be left alone. We can protect them. You know, they have an important job to do. And let's be honest, they're super cool. We appreciate you watching our video on sharks and we hope to see you next video.